psyched. I'm super psyched. It is a new month, February, which means we have a new word of the month that we're going to be talking about. And I'm not going to tell you what it is yet. You have to wait to find out, because first we have to worship God and thank Him for getting us through January, and thank Him for a new month, and thank Him for the snow, which we all know that we love. Are you guys ready? Let's do this. Get ready. Warm it up. All right, let's go. You guys ready to worship? Here we go.
Thank you. little bit. This love is like wow, so let's go right now.
Put your whole self in, put your whole self out. Are you ready?
Check it out! Good job!
Put your whole self in, jump up and dance around.
Are you ready?
Worshiping guys, I knew you could be awesome. I've seen it before. And now that we did that, it is time to learn what our new word of the month is. Are you ready? Because I'm ready. I'm so excited. I'm gonna whisper because that's how excited I am. I'm so excited. I'm trying to contain my excited attitude. Whispers that I can't even say words because I'm so excited. Okay. Our word starts with a K, so try and make a K with your body. I don't know if it goes this way or this way. This way, this way. Make a K with your body. All right. Our word. Oh, it's already up there. Our word of the month is kindness. Oh, did you guys catch that it was already up there before I caught that it was already up there? You guys probably did because you're way smarter than me. Kindness is our word of the month. Kindness is showing others that they are valuable by the way that you treat them. That's right. It means that you're treating them the way that you act towards people, the way that you behave towards people, the way that you are around people shows people whether they are worth it or not, whether they are valuable or not. So we kind of want to show them kindness because we want them to know that they're worth it. We want them to know that they're valuable. God puts people in our lives and we want to show them kindness. But that's not always easy. You guys know what I'm talking about. Probably mainly those people with siblings, right? Sometimes those siblings, I'll tell you, it is hard to treat them with kindness. It's so hard. But maybe it's not your siblings. Maybe sometimes those people are your parents. Maybe sometimes those people are your friends. Maybe those people are your enemies. Sometimes it is hard to be nice to people. It is hard to treat people with kindness, especially if those people are being mean to you. When somebody says or does something mean to you, maybe you automatically want to say or do something mean right back at them, right? It's kind of like this picture that I'm going to put up here, this video. When one person does something mean to you, and then you do something mean to them, and then it just goes back and forth and back and forth, right? Back and forth and back and forth. You're mean, and then they're mean. And then you're mean, and then they're mean, or they're mean, and then you're mean, and then they're mean, and then you're mean, and then they're, and then they're. It just keeps going on. That's called revenge. Revenge is never a good idea, guys. It just keeps going. That's not what God wants us to do. It's not how He wants us to treat people. He wants us to take the step in kindness. A long time ago, in the times of the Bible, in the New Testament, which is the back of the Bible, that's right, Jesus times, There's a guy named Paul who loved Jesus. He followed Jesus, but that wasn't always the case. See, Paul did a lot of bad stuff before he followed Jesus. But when he did follow Jesus, he taught other people how to follow Jesus. And when he did this, he wrote letters to some of them. And in his letters to the people called Ephesians, he taught them that they should forgive. He told the Ephesians that when people did mean stuff to them or said mean stuff to them, they should forgive them because Jesus forgives them. God brought us Jesus, and then Jesus died on the cross to take the blame for all of the wrong things that we do, to forgive us for all of the bad choices that we make, to forgive us, not to revenge, but to show us kindness. Paul says that we should take that example from God, from Jesus, and show it to others. And who better to say that than Paul? Because Paul knows that he did a bunch of bad things. He made a bunch of bad choices. And Paul knows that Jesus has forgiven all of his bad choices. Let me show you something. All of you have probably used one of these before. Maybe not quite as big, but all of you have probably used a whiteboard before. You all know that with a whiteboard, you have special markers that you can use. You use them on the whiteboard. Can you see the smiley face? And then you just erase it and it comes right off, right? But what happens if instead of using a special marker, I used a permanent marker? Uh-oh. Frowny face. You know, using this permanent marker is kind of like making a mistake, messing up, making a bad choice, right? When someone makes a bad choice, someone hurts us. But there's something that we can do about that. There's something you can do to make it better. We're going to take our special marker. And here's what you can do to make this. Because look, they can't fix it. They hurt you, and they can't fix it. There's nothing they can do to do change it. We can erase it. I can move my arm as quickly as possible, and it still won't go away. But you can make it better. You can make the hurt by, what do you think I'm gonna say? What can you do to make this all better? Yes, we did just draw over the family face, but that's not what you can do when somebody hurts you. Forgiving, right? Forgiving. That'll make it better. Now, I'm not saying that when somebody does something wrong towards you, when somebody does something hurtful to you, that if you forgive them, it'll make it magically disappear. That's not what I'm saying. It won't. It still happened. But forgiving it can give you a fresh start. It can make you have a new start to your friendship, right? Maybe this is your chance to show kindness to each other and you can still be friends. Or if you weren't friends before, you can now be friends. Forgiving doesn't mean forgetting what happened. It just means allowing you and your friend or you and that person to move on to the next thing. And hopefully that next thing is something good. God shows his kindness through forgiveness and love. And we can do the same thing. We can take God's example of forgiveness and kindness and show that to others. And you know what happens when we do that? It's contagious. You know how people say when you yawn, somebody else is gonna yawn, and then somebody else is gonna yawn because it's contagious, a yawn is contagious? Well, kindness is the same thing. Some of you may have heard me say this, but when you compliment somebody or when you smile at somebody, those things are also contagious. Try it. When you're out, well, super hard right now because obviously masks, right? So hard. But when you're in your house, if you just walk around and notice somebody's not smiling in your house, just turn around to them and just smile. Like not a devious smile, because then they'll be like, what are you up to? But do like a nice smile and then they'll smile back at you. See what happens. Kindness is contagious. It's kind of like this. Let me show you. Check it out. I have some dominoes here and in the shape of a C. That's right. C for compliments. And let's see what happens when I knock over one of the dominoes. You ready? Sorry about the shakiness. Boom! The first domino showed a compliment and it kept going. Then the second one complimented, the third one, then they all complimented around the circle. It was a compliment fall down. Kindness is contagious, and forgiving is just the first step that we can show other people that we value them, that they are valuable. How can you show kindness this week? How can you forgive somebody this week? I want you to think about that. That's your question of the week. How can you show kindness to someone this week? Maybe that's forgiving somebody. All right, we're gonna pray. I want you guys to lean over like you're a falling domino. Are you ready? Here we go. I'm gonna lean forward like I'm a falling domino. Here we go. God, thank you so much for being an example of kindness for us. Thank you for sending us Jesus to die on the cross for us, and for forgiving us for the bad choices we make. We may not deserve them, but you forgive us anyway, and you show us your love every day. Help us to do the same thing to others when they hurt us and when they're mean to us. Help us to remember not to show them revenge, but to show them kindness, to forgive them, and to show them love. In your name we pray. Everybody said, amen. Fall over. All the way over. Ready? Did you fall over? Okay. I'll see you guys next week. Oh, hey. So next week, I'm going to start doing primetime shout outs. So if you guys want to shout out during primetime, I want you guys to have your parents email me, text me, call me, send me a message on Facebook or Instagram, any of those things, and I'll give you a shout out. I'm gonna do 2 shout outs during primetime each week, but you have to watch the whole primetime because I'm not gonna do them in the same spot each week, and I'm not gonna do each name in the same spot. You're gonna have to wait and see when I do them. It's gonna be so exciting. So shout outs, maybe with pictures. If you want your picture to pop up too, we can do shout outs with pictures. Maybe I'll do like a cutout and be like, you're right here. Face on a stick. Okay, until next week, miss you guys, love you guys, bye.